Log into your Microsoft Fabric account, then click on Synapse Real-Time Analytics, then click on Workspaces, then click on your Workspace, then click on your KQL Database. If you are not familiar with how to create a KQL database and how to load the file from your local system, please watch my other videos. I'll put link in the description below. In the last video, we have loaded the data from our local system to our KQL database. Then we have write some KQL basic queries, and we also learned how we can use the SQL query within the KQL database. But now in this video, we will learn what is the use of the KQL query set, and then we will build the Power BI report. So to create a KQL query set, click on new related item, then click on KQL query set. Provide name to your KQL query set, then click on create. Here you can see it has provided you the basic information to create the KQL query. Just type your table, then take 100. It will give you the any 100 rows from your table. Then if you want to check the count from a table, then table name, pipe and count. And if you want to check the last 1 hour records, just write this query. Let me delete all this. To get all the records from your table, type the table name. Then select it and click on run. It will give you all the records from your table. And suppose if you want only 10 records, then type table name, enter, pipe, take 10. Select it, then click on run. It will give you any 10 records. And if you want only account ID and frequency column, for that, what you can do, just type table name, pipe, project function and column names. Select it, then click on run. So this is how you can choose the columns from your table. And suppose if you want to rename your column, so for that, you before column name, write the name which you want to give your column. Select it, then click on run. Here you can see my column name is changed. Within the KQL query set, you can write multiple queries, and as well as you can run all the queries. Let me show you. Let me write the second query to get the record from bank client details. And we need to provide the semicolon for both the queries. Select all queries, then click on run. Here you can see we got the output of both the tables. Let me write a query to get the data from bank disposition. Select all, then click on run. And one more thing, you can write the SQL query within the KQL query set. So for that, simply write select star from table name. Select it, then run. You can see we got the output. Here you can see we have some KQL query and one SQL query. We can't run all the queries at once. Let me try it. Select all, then click on run. It will give you error. And one more thing, you can't create the Power BI dashboard on SQL query within the KQL query set. Here you can see this is not available. And when I click on any KQL query, you can see it appears. Now, what I'll do, I'll join all the tables based on key columns. So in bank account, we have account ID, and in bank client details, we have client ID, and in bank disposition data, we have disposition ID, client ID, and account ID. And in bank user card details, we have disposition ID. So first, I'll join bank account and disposition data based on account ID. Find equal to kind equal to inner, second table name is bank disposition data, on left table dot account ID equal to right dot account ID, double equal to we need to provide. Then we need to join with client details. Join client equal to inner bank client details on left table column, which is client ID, and for right table client ID, the last table is our user card detail. Join kind equal to inner bank user card details on left column is disposition ID, and right table column is disposition ID. Select it, then run. You can see we got all the columns from all tables, but we need only some selective columns. Write pipe project and column name. I'll select account ID, frequency, type, first name and last name, city and state, then card type, which is under type 1 column. So we have two type columns within two different tables. That's why in the output query, one is renamed as type 1. To rename it, just type card underscore type equal to type 1. Then select all. Click on run. You can see we got the selected column. We can't create the Power BI dashboard for all the queries at once. We need to select only one. So I want to develop the Power BI report on this query. Let me select it, then click on Build Power BI report. Here you can see we got the Power BI window. At the right hand side, you can see we got all the selected columns from our query. Now using these columns, you can develop your report. So first we will create a card for total number of accounts. Click on it, then drag account ID and choose count distinct. So we have 892 accounts. Give name to this card. Go here and click on this. Your label is off. Now we will give the title to this chart. Click on general, then click on title. Total accounts. In the middle, and increase the size to 20. Now we will create a pie chart and we will segregate accounts by card type. Click on pie chart, then take card type into legend and account ID into values. Do count distinct. So here you can see we have three types of card: Visa Signature, Visa Standard and Visa Infinite. Rename this chart. Go to journal. Title accounts by card type. Resize it. Then move it to middle. Now we will show the accounts by state. So for that we will use Azure map. Click on it, then select state in location and resize it. Then provide the title to your chart. Click here, click on journal and title. Type accounts by state. Now go to file and save our report. Click on save. Give name to your report. Then choose your workspace. Click on continue. Our report is saved successfully. Close this. Now go to your workspace. Here you can see our report. Click on it. You can see the report which we have developed earlier. So this is how you can design your Power BI report over KQL query set. That's it in this video. In the next video, we will learn how we can use the event stream, and using the event stream, we will load the real-time data into the KQL database. Thank you for watching this video.